Hey guys, thanks for clicking in. Using a simple stick in baseball. There's a couple ways that I use it in pitchers that I wanted to share with you guys. One of the things that I teach, or Top Velocity teaches also, as we lift up our leg, we're going to lead with our hip. We don't want to get our shoulders into this position where our front shoulder gets out in front of our hip. That's usually going to depict into a dirt ball, one down low. So we want to keep our shoulders, and if we lead with the hip, we'll actually get a little counter backwards, that we land on the right spot when we land. So one of the things that I do with the pitchers is I'll stand behind them and I'll hold this stick right on their hip where their femur connects into their hip bone. It's kind of down low. You know, where if you lift your leg up, where that L, where the bend is, that's where you want to put that stick. And then you want to let them know, as you lift your leg, as soon as you lift your leg, this leg is very similar to like a train brake where your foot's down on it, the brake of the train is on. As soon as you lift off that brake, that train starts to move. Now, it doesn't go really quick, but it's a slow, and then they go. But I want them to feel like they're pushing their hip out. So when they lift up, they're feeling that pressure on the front side, and they start pushing that hip out as they lift up their leg and move forward. It's a good feel drill to have them lifting up on the initial move and getting their body going and really leading with their hip, which is really, really good for a pitcher to do. And then secondly, what's not so good for a pitcher to do is a lot of times when they come way back here behind them, because then they have to pull the front side just to get it back into this position and hyperangulate the back arm. So when they come way back there, why don't you put a fence or a border up there? Stick comes into play number two. So you're holding that stick, again, you're standing behind them, and you're holding that stick so that if they come back here, they're gonna hit that stick and feel that fence or border, and that's their base point that they're starting off of. So next time, hopefully they'll come here and get that feel not into the stick. So two good drills that you can do with sticks. There's a bunch of other drills that I do. There's some separation drills where I keep this up on my head, drive my hips, and keep my upper half closed. So what it looks like is this is gonna stay right on the camera, but the lower half turns. So I drive, turn. And you can even put some more torque into it. When you drive out, you can turn in and really help separate even more. So a drive and a turn, a drive and a turn. All these things help separate the upper body from the lower body. And we know that when hip to shoulder separation occurs, there's big influences to peaking up the velocity. So guys, thanks for clicking in. Hope you enjoyed the little stick drill. But plenty more out there. Let us know if you have any that you can share with us. Nuke out.